Making a life worth living and retirement worth having is really about helping people to see themselves in a way that makes sense to the rest of the world, not in their own opinions of themselves. Now let's think about that for a moment. You see, every person in the world has a soul, and every soul has a lineage of sorts in the way that the Bible talks about how we are linked through history, through generation, through parentage, through all sorts of bloodlines to the one who saves us all. At least that is the rhetoric and the marketing liaison of the Christian religious movement. Now, am I making fun of it? No, I'm not. I'm literally putting it into a legalized term. You see, practically, there are bloodlines that connect us to other people, but in reality, it does not mean that legally, under the law, we are related to them exactly. You see, as a person becomes mature, as they become into adulthood, they become their own person. They literally have their own rights, their own legalities, their own abilities to do things under their own name, their own business profession, their own personal life, and openly every other legal aspect of their life in terms of paperwork is literally theirs alone. It belongs to no other person. Yes, we have family members who can be concerned about our life. Yes, we practically can have fellowship with people in our congregations of whatever sort of philosophy we are practicing or learning about or educational institution that might have concerns or interests in our life. But they have no lawful rights to our life. And that is something that lawyers do a good job of explaining under the laws. You see, contract law is one sort of law. Constitutional law is another sort of law. International human rights law is another sort of law. Occasionally, those laws interact with each other. Occasionally, those laws overlap each other. It doesn't really matter. What matters is whether or not people are voyeuring on another person's life or whether they're truly involved in a person's life. You see, you can't be involved in a person's life if there's no one actually involved in that life. You see, involvement implies a regular meeting, a positive interaction, a social club, if you will, a regular outing, a meal together, a coffee together, something that actually produces a relationship. Talking at one another, yelling at one another of sorts in people's lives in certain families does not constitute a relationship by many people's standards. Well, there are tons of books in the libraries and at the bookstores about what produces a healthy relationship. Someone managing or manhandling someone's life illegally is not a relationship. Legal bounds do exist. Where someone's life begins and another life ends is totally at the hands of the law. You see, professionally, we all have legal relationships to the companies in which we perform our duties for. When we represent an organization, we take that stationery and we utilize it for some sort of a letter, we create a unique situation. I remember this very well long ago because I was very young in my understanding of my rights working for a company. I was literally in my college years, and I wanted to learn more about other equipment that were out there. I didn't realize that by putting my name on letterhead and sending letters, I was actually representing a larger portion of my entire company that had several stations and several locations and even a divisional manager who normally did those things. I was just looking at how do I get taken seriously as a younger professional in relation to these company representatives who I'd like to get some information for just so that we have more information so that when customers ask us about certain products, we would have an educational base of literature and professional brochures that once used to be a part of the marketing place for products and services in the photographic industry, that it would be okay to have those brochures available to show customers. So if they wanted to special order, we would be able to do it more carefully with more current literature as opposed to historic stuff that was literally out of date, grimy from being in files and cobwebs for a long period of time. But I learned the hard way in that moment of time that lawfully, I didn't have the right to represent the company that way. I ended up having to apologize for my naivety at that time in my life, but it was really okay. You see, when people think they have the lawful right to do things to others, they don't really have that lawful right. They really have to pretend and prevent themselves from doing something illegal on someone's name. They can continue to think they're doing something lawfully, but they really aren't. They're pretending to be something that they're not, which is illegal. And openly, that is what the law is about. Now, when someone says, I am this or that, they have to prove it under the law. Once all those laws have been affected and impacted and changed, it is no one else's rights to go in and say, I'm sorry, that's not true. That's not their lawful right. You see, that's what we're talking about here, lawful rights, and I'm giving an example of a story from my point of view. I'm also allowing people to see that I practice the faith, and that's not their right to say anything about underneath the U.S. Constitution. I literally have the right to do anything I like as long as I'm not impacting someone else's rights. Isn't that really the realities of human rights? Human rights practically say that if I literally need to use a toilet, that someone in a restaurant or someone in a store should actually allow me to use their toilet, as long as I'm not trying to take anything, as long as I'm just doing my business and getting the hell out of there, because practically it is a human right to have a clean toilet. It's also a human right to have fresh water that is untainted and food that is not manipulated by someone without one's consent. Those are international human rights underneath the Declaration of Human Rights. You see, we have constitutional rights too. The constitutional rights allow us freedom of movement, freedom of religion, freedom of press, freedom of assembly, freedom of a lot of things. But people don't always think about that when they're interacting with others. They get it and they make it too personal. By making it too personal, they overlook the laws that protect their rights. And when people get pissed off enough, they end up going to lawyers and suing people for the violation of their rights. And that's the reality, that when someone manipulates the law to produce something that is not correct on someone else's life, people do get upset. They literally do rage about it. They literally do get livid, and they do go to the law because that is what is accustomed now. In the old days of the West, someone just would literally pull out a six-shooter and blast somebody away. We don't do that anymore because we believe in the human rights to life. Right to life of a person's life to go on in their life without someone damaging them, mutilating them, destroying them, beating them up, or murdering them. That actually is a law. It's not a silly law, it is a factual law. So when people try to put people to sleep and do things to their body, that is also illegal. You see, I'm talking about laws now. Does it make sense to you? You see, the mayhem in the world is because of people who violate simple laws that were put into place by our forefathers to make sure that people's rights were completely heard, completely observed, and completely understood. You see, where my rights begin and where your little rights end are totally two different spots, not exactly. Where my rights end is where your rights might begin, or it might be someone else's rights that begin there. But literally, we don't know unless we start really thinking about the law. I am not legally dependent on any person, but I sometimes get a little help as I'm going through this struggle of a transition. Now, does that mean that the person who's helping me has some legal rights to my name or my property or my personhood or my finances or any of those sort of things? No, it actually does not. It means they're giving a gift. They're giving a gift that if they want to put parameters on it, they can, but those parameters have to be negotiated. This is not a dictatorship of any kind, shape, or form in America. We are a democracy. We allow people to negotiate, to prepare, to provide information to others, and we don't have to literally say everything that we're doing to some total stranger so that they feel good in their life about what they're observing. That is not their legal right. Their boundaries are theirs, my boundaries are mine, and that's the point of this audio cast, that if we're not paying attention to laws, we can really fuck ourselves up, excuse the language, and I should really practically work on that part as a Christian man and as a creationist-oriented person, that literally the language that we have in our life really does come from the Lord in heaven. There are people who literally think that they have the lawful right to open someone's vehicle and take things literally out of it. There are people who think that if the window is open, that that's an invitation to unlock a door of a vehicle. There are people in this world who think that if there's an open window or a screen, that they can cut that screen and go into someone's house. Now, isn't that illegal and immoral and illicit? Absolutely it is, and yet there are people who think they have the literal right to do that. There are people who think they have the right to receive money from someone else on someone's legal name. That may or may not be lawful. We have to really look at that. If the relationship is on a contract with one person's name, then really that is the person who is legally liable and responsible for every activity that goes on within that particular agreement. Someone else might like to help and might like to donate and might like to gift and might like to help someone save their virtual household items or their house or their rent or any of those sort of things, but that does not literally give them the lawful right to go into that home and do one thing in that home. Isn't that the rights of the law? So when I'm talking about the law, I'm talking about things that make sense, don't I? In reality, I am not about to go to your house, open the door without your permission, walk into the house and start pilfering through your drawers and looking at your undergarments and all sorts of things like that. Not only is that highly socially inappropriate in reality to social relationships and social protocols, but it is absolutely the truth that when we see things in the world, we have to note them. We have to realize that people have rights. You have rights to your home. You have rights to your property. You have rights to your discretionary income that literally purchased those things. And literally no one else, no matter who they are, no matter what relationship they think they have with you, has the right to take those items from your personage, from your property, meaning your land, from your home, meaning the place in where you reside, whether that be a residence in a mobile vehicle of sorts, or whether that residence be a mobile home that literally could be put on the back of a truck with wheels, or whether that's literally an actual house, a residence, and even a rental property. You see, all property owners have rights, but we're literally talking about the legalities of the law. Now, some people and families sort of misunderstand the law. They think just because this person is my sibling or my child, that I have rights that extend above and beyond the law. And when a person is an adult, that is not actually factual. That is a lie that they tell themselves, and it literally is why we have so many litigation cases that could have literally been avoided if the people understood where the law line laid. You see, the law line is with the individual, him or herself. Now, if a person does something like pull a gun on someone, that literally is liable to the person who pulled the gun, not the person who was simply trying to talk to that individual. I really feel that that's an important law, but I'm not sure where that is on the book. So if you actually know, please let me know. I believe that law enforcement is supposed to have a conversation before they pull a gun on someone. And openly, did that person really feel threatened, or did they actually just lie about feeling threatened because they couldn't understand what was going on? To me, that seems like a fear-based reaction, an unhealthy practice of sorts. And openly, most people would rather talk a few things out before they get into fisticuffs or they literally get into a gun situation, which is actually illegal. So I don't quite understand gun laws in the world. We're allowed to protect yourself, but if we pull a gun on somebody, we better have a damn well good reason for it. But openly, did someone getting out of a vehicle make a threat to someone? I don't literally think so. Now, I'm not going to talk much more about this in this audio cast, but the law is the law. The law is that I can practice any faith-based religion that I want. The law is that I can provide myself help in certain situations as long as I use the proper channels, follow the rules, and do what I feel is right for myself. And in this case, I am lawfully saying my rights are mine and your rights are yours. Now, if these audio casts make sense to you, I'd really appreciate a shout out. I'd really appreciate someone who's listening out there to go, you know, you're making sense. It doesn't matter whether or not it's something that I'm dying to listen to right now, but what you're saying makes sense under the law. This has been Blake Ensign of Blaze Communications, LLC, marketing himself across the audio waves of our universe and openly getting tired of people who think they're smart enough to think that it's not lawful to do so. We are allowed to market ourselves into positions and into other opportunities by the way we talk to those that we need to talk to. And we have to make new introductions sometimes to get into new industries, to change our lives, to do all sorts of practical things that doesn't allow someone else to just decide, I'm going to up and do something because I feel like it. There are people who do generous things. There are do-gooders in the world who simply just pay for somebody's lunch because they think it's a kindness to do to someone who's struggling. There are people who literally help a person move with no expectation of their own to take things, to steal things, to remove things from a person's property. There are storage facilities that supposedly do this, but hey, I'm not talking about anything other than the law. The law is that contractually we are liable for what we've signed our name to. If someone has missed a payment, then it's up to the company to say, hey, just want you to know you missed your payment. Can we help you figure out what to do to make that payment? Or if literally you're not getting your mail because someone is unlawfully stealing your mail, it's kind of hard to know that you got a payment due. You see, there's all sorts of laws that get impacted by the way that we interact with people. The reality is that when we're looking at others, we have to decide whether or not we have the right to sit there and stare, or whether we literally have the right to just listen, or whether we have the right to say, hey, that sounds like a good audio cast. Where is it playing on? You see, there's all kinds of ways to produce a relationship with someone, but voyeuring in on someone's life is not always the best way to go about it. Taking things from people's vehicle is most definitely not the way to go about it, and lying to people as if you're a representative of that person's name is most certainly a way to get yourself into a lawsuit. Once again, this has been Blake Ensign of Blaze Communications, LLC, talking about the magic and mayhem of life, that in life we have magic that is given to us by the Heavenly Father and Heavenly Mother that's a divine creator of the universe, and we have mayhem that people put in our lives because they failed to follow the law. Whether it's the law in the Bible is one thing, or whether it's the law of the land is another, or whether it's international in general about human rights and people's right to civil liberties, that's another thing entirely. I hope you're making it a great day in a lawful way.